Hello, this is Matt on the Moon Lambo channel. Ripple's Senior Vice President of Marketing, Monica Long, was interviewed today on Bloomberg, and she had a lot to say about cryptocurrency in general, regulation, and Facebook's Libra. So I'm going to be covering some of that for you. Also, exciting news, we've got SBI Virtual Currencies going live, and they are an XRapid-enabled exchange, so I'm going to share some information with you on that. And also, we've got a news article from CoinDesk, and there's a statement from Facebook acknowledging that their cryptocurrency, Libra, may never be launched. So before we get going here, if you would please delicately tap that like button. And if you are a fan of Ripple and XRP, subscribe. It's the right thing to do. It's the best thing we'll do all day. Hit subscribe. It's a good time. Into the content before I sound even more stupid. So here's the tweet from Ripple. And it links to the Bloomberg video, which I encourage you to check out. It's only a little over 4 minutes. But anyway, Ripple tweeted out, this is a quote from Monica Long, "Within any industry, there are responsible actors and bad actors. A good regulatory framework sets up responsible actors to innovate and improve efficiencies in the global financial system." Indeed. It was really well spoken, by the way. You know, one of my favorite questions that she was asked in this particular piece is, now that, the Libra White Paper is out, Facebook's, they're talking to the politicians, talking to Congress, and they're receiving a lot of pushback, what does that mean? What does that mean for you guys? What does that mean for cryptocurrency in general? And I'm kind of paraphrasing, but that's basically what she was asked. And she said, well, we want it to be known that Facebook doesn't speak for everyone in the world of blockchain, in the world of crypto. And she made it clear that, and this is, she's not the only Ripple employee to state this, but cryptocurrencies are different. They have different attributes. They're technologically different. They're being used for different things. And as regulations are written, this has to be acknowledged. Otherwise, you risk, as we've said before, throwing the baby out with the bathwater. Don't throw out babies. They're humans. Don't do that. I know it sounds like, to you and I, it probably sounds like common sense, but when you're talking about Congress, many of these people having no understanding of this at all, which, by the way, I can sympathize with. I remember when I jumped into crypto, I didn't know what the hell was going on. But these people, they need to take a thoughtful approach. And it's much like, as she stated in this particular video clip, it's much like what went down in the 90s when, thankfully, the United States did the right thing and they did introduce thoughtful regulation, which made it possible for good actors, good innovators to bring their ingenuity to the world, thanks to the emerging technology that was the internet. And so just like that happened back then, she says, hey, we just need that again today. And she acknowledged, because she was asked, what about people that think that this cryptocurrency stuff, kind of shady stuff, people aren't using it for such good things, nefarious activities, this and that. And she acknowledged that, but she said, you're just going to have to listen to the way she worded it, but she effectively said, look, there are bad actors in any space, and it doesn't mean that the underlying technology is inherently bad. And that's definitely true. There are bad apples in any crowd, aren't there? So, very well spoken in my mind, and I it's just amazing to me because Brad Garlinghouse was just on this television program with this same host about a week ago. Ripple is all over the freaking place in the media today. I'm absolutely loving this. I am eating it up. As an XRP community member who is a rather strong enthusiast, I think this is fantastic stuff, and I really enjoy covering it too. So tell me if you guys got thoughts on this below, but there's obviously a lot going on in terms of Congress acknowledging the world of crypto. And, for better or worse, it's been pushed to the forefront of everyone's mind thanks to Facebook's white paper. I didn't say cryptocurrency, I said thanks to their white paper, because the cryptocurrency doesn't exist and might not ever exist. But I guess, look, it's going to get regulated one way or another at some point, so I guess I'm appreciative that this is moving forward, even if it is true that Facebook was, as Brad Garlinghouse said, perhaps being arrogant in a Silicon Valley fashion, essentially, because, whatever, if it speeds things up, it speeds things up. So that's where we're at on that here. And again, I'll link this below. Now check out this. Oh, I wanted to share this with you. I'm going to be real brief on this because I covered this in my last video, but it was the piece about the United States SEC is going to be running an XRP node along with Bitcoin and Ethereum and well as well. And so somebody named Ripple Rob tagged Galgatron in this, and just wanted to kind of get another opinion on this, and I thought I'd share with you another opinion on this. And he writes, is this a method in which the SEC can monitor / police whale manipulation? And Galgatron responded to this, no, they would be mostly looking for money laundering and other nefarious on-chain activity, plus these nodes would give them some expertise in the process. Whale mitigation is entirely on exchanges, and the surveillance toolset borrowed from the stock market is highly advanced. And I think that speaks for itself. I just thought I'd throw this in here because when I made my last video, Galgatron's response didn't exist. But just another perspective, so I thought I'd share with you. All right, now check this out. This I got from, well, actually, I originally saw news of this from, technically, there we go, XRP Crypto Wolf. And I'm going to read XRP Crypto Wolf's tweet in just a moment. But then I saw a tweet from Alex Cobb, and he wrote a piece on it, and I wanted to share with you the content from the piece that he wrote up, since there's a bit more detail to it rather than what you just see in what people are able to tweet out with the character limitation anyway. So anyway, Alex Cobb tweeted this out. Big day for the XRP community. Huge step forward for enabling XRP utility. Great info in this article below regarding SBI VC MoneyTap and how this is going to lead to banks using XRP. And the piece is titled here on the XRP Daily, which is Alex Cobb's website. He titled it SBI VC Trade Confirmed to Go Live Today, the first bank-backed XRapid enabled exchange. I'm assuming that's a mistake. I read this whole article, and from everything else I saw, it's supposed to go live on the 31st. Today is the 30th. If I'm being an idiot and I missed something, please drop a comment below. I may have actually legitimately just somehow missed something, but I think this is a mistake, actually. I think that Alex meant the 31st. Regardless, the content within this piece I still want to share with you because it's completely valid, regardless of whether or not the day it's launching was accurately actually made known anyway. And then here's the tweet from XRP Crypto Wolf before I read a little bit more about it. Tweets out, SBI VC Trade announced that trading will go live July 31st, 2019, which again is tomorrow. Available trading pairs, XRP to Yen, Bitcoin Yen, and Ethereum to Yen. SBI Virtual Currencies Trade also announced that it will be transferred to SBI Securities in the second half of 2020. Now let me read some of this piece here from the XRP Daily. Today is a big day for the XRP community. The first ever bank-backed XRapid-enabled exchange is launching today and will be providing liquidity for the XRP/JPY when banks start using XRapid for cross-border settlement. Just today, five banks were officially added to the MoneyTap application, making it a total of 25 banks now using the Ripple-enabled MoneyTap, and Yoshitaka Katao is stating that they want to use XRapid because they are expanding MoneyTap to serve international payments. With SBI VC Trade launching today, that now opens the door for that to happen because banks in Japan will now have a reliable source of liquidity for XRP. And somebody named Dylan on Twitter here sent this out. SBI CEO Yoshitaka Katao, and this is a quote, we have 25 participating banks and 8 are API platform connected with Ripple. We want MoneyTap to accommodate international remittance, so we created a mechanism and it may contribute to XRapid using XRP. All right, so and then he continues here in the piece. We are talking banks. Actual banks are going to be using XRapid. It doesn't just stop at 25. There's a total of 61 banks in the SBI Ripple Asia Consortium. SBI has confirmed that MoneyTap will be expanded to all of the 61 banks over time. That is 80% of the banking assets in Japan, possibly leveraging the digital asset XRP in the near future. And that's a very valid point. By the way, every time I see developments like this, it gets me excited because I start thinking about the global implications of this as it pertains to XRP being utilized as a bridge currency, because Ripple is just building a crazy amount of corridors. And of course, all the banks in Japan themselves, there's not a need to utilize XRP as a bridge currency because they're just using their own local fiat. But if they want to move money the rest of the world over, yup, it's going to be highly useful. And all of these banks, that's a lot of banks in Japan that will be able, it's already tied into RippleNet, that will be able to use it. So this is big stuff. Just the tracks are being laid, and then you got to be patient. And then, adoption is coming because, like I always say, if you can save money, and it provides a better customer experience, what do you think banks and financial institutions are going to do? They're just going to throw out this highly useful technology? No, that is not what's going to happen. All right, anyway, the piece continues here. Perhaps we may see all Japanese banks using XRP in the future, because the other 20% aren't going to stand a chance unless they convert to RippleNet. Well, that's true as it pertains to cross-border. Of course, banks do a lot of other stuff. But yeah, I think that's a valid point that Alex made there, that in terms of offering their customers rates and customer service as it pertains to cross-border payments, yeah, if you want to try competing against a bank that's utilizing XRapid and not offer that and just go through the traditional SWIFT network utilizing Nostro accounts, I don't know about that. I'd rather not lose my business, so I lose business to the competitor, so I think I'd rather adapt. Anyway, and then he writes, a valued XRP community member, Crypto Eddie, who is very familiar with the Japanese language, confirms the announcement from SBI about the launch date of SBI VC Trade. And then she tweeted out, physical trading, the sales board, will be live tomorrow in Japan, July 31st, on SBI VC Trade, per a briefing today from Mr. Katao. A special XRP campaign giveaway is planned for both volume and new account opening soon. More to follow in video. And again, she wrote July 31st, which is tomorrow, so I'm assuming that was a typo in the title here. But anyway, and then it concludes by writing, as I am writing this, it is currently 4:31 a.m. in Japan. The server maintenance will start at 6 a.m. until 6 p.m. However, SBI did state that it could be shortened or could go longer. No matter what, though, SBI VC Trade is launching as an order book exchange July 31st, 2019. This is a big step forward for enabling XRP utility. Yes, indeed, indeed. All right, on to the next piece here. I just thought I'd point this out because nobody's perfect. We all love Ripple here, but their website's messing up today, and it's kind of comical, so I thought I'd share it with you. Here's a tweet from Tiffany Hayden, and she just writes, their website is messed up. I most certainly did not apply. And then if you click on this, it says, thank you for your interest. It says, thanks for applying to Ripple. We will review your application and be in touch if you seem like a good fit for the position. In the meantime, feel free to check out other available jobs at Ripple. Thanks again and good luck in your job search. And so I was like, oh, okay. I can imagine if I clicked on that, I'm sorry, I did what now? No, I did not just apply. And XRP Research Center got the same error here. And then somebody named Coins ASCII. I don't know how to say it. Anyway, writes, since 10 minutes, I have accidentally a new job. I will replace Brad Garlinghouse as CEO at Ripple. Kidding. So I was like, that's all right. We love Ripple. I'm sure they'll fix the website. All right, now check this out. On to the next piece. There's a tweet from Simon G. And it was a retweet from somebody named A Gray Man. He tweeted out, I could be going mad, but didn't this say 1,500 transactions before? And then it's referencing the Ripple website, which talks about the scalability of XRP, and it says throughput capacity over 50,000 transactions a second. And so you may be well aware of this, but XRP, the transaction per second, it maxes out at like what 1,500 per second. And takes the average transaction takes 3 to 5 seconds, but probably all know that. I assume maybe less people are aware that the technology is scalable to up to 50,000 transactions per second, but that is not done on chain anyway. And so Galagatron responded, they're talking about pay channels, not on ledger. And then somebody named Crypto Al responded, Wayback Machine shows it at 50,000 transactions in March as well. And then Galgatron responded, it's a very old number. Pay channels have much higher velocity because it's peer-to-peer. And this is more on the tech side, and I don't know exactly how this worked. There was a time a while back I asked Matt Hamilton, who is at Hammertoe on Twitter, and he is just a wealth of knowledge also on the technology side of this. I was like, so how does this actually work? And I responded to him with what I think I heard from him via the writing anyway. And it just sounded like transactions can somehow be batched together and sent through. That's the only way I can simplify, try and explain it in layman's terms. With, I mean, I am a layman, right? But I can't give a more in-depth technical response. But that was what I was made to understand. How is it possible to increase from 1,500 transactions per second to 50,000? And it was basically that a bunch are sent through and it counts as one. That's the most I can dumb it down. And that was my interpretation from what Matt Hamilton said. If there's a better way to describe that, or if I'm slightly off in any way in which I just explained that, please let me know, because I'm always always happy to learn more. I'm always looking to learn more. But that's what I'm aware of, so I'm just sharing with you what I had gotten after asking Matt Hamilton. All right, and last thing I'm going to cover in this particular video here. This is a piece from CoinDesk. Excuse me. It's titled, Facebook Libra Might Never Launch. Company Concedes in SEC Disclosure. Facebook has acknowledged what many have been saying, that regulatory issues may be an insurmountable barrier to the launch of its Libra Global cryptocurrency project. In a frank disclosure in the firm's latest quarterly report to the United States Securities and Exchange Commission, the firm said that the many barriers it will face regarding regulating a new technology with unclear rules in the United States and other nations of the world mean there can be no assurance that Libra or our associated products and services will be made available in a timely manner or at all. Our participation in the Libra Association will subject us to significant regulatory scrutiny and other risks that could adversely affect our business reputation or financial results, Facebook says. And not only is Libra based on relatively new and unproven technology, the laws and regulations around digital currency are uncertain and evolving. Does this not make it, with this being written up, does this not make you think that, maybe Facebook, you should have talked to the regulators instead of just being like, yeah, hey, we're doing this, deal with it, mofos. Like, maybe you really should have talked to them a little bit more first, like Ripple was doing. You know what? They've been doing all sorts of stuff. And then they developed XCurrent and XRapid. Okay, it's like, oh, Lord. But yeah, that's not how they did it. Now, even so, since I'm not Facebook and I have no vested interest in them, I am kind of happy they did it, just because it seems like it's getting people to talk about this sooner in a more serious manner than they otherwise would have. So even if the writing's on the wall for Facebook's Libra coin and it never actually happens, it still served its purpose, sort of. But no, I mean, who knows? Maybe it will be launched today. I'm just not exactly sure. And I don't know that it's something. I just can't imagine a world where I personally, me in my own life, would find it useful to use Libra. United States dollars working pretty good for me, and I don't need additional friction in my payments. So, and that's what I think it would result in for me. That's why I see, for me today, I don't see, if I were to switch to using a cryptocurrency for daily payments, that would be like one of the most irritating things I could possibly do. Like, I don't want to punish myself like that. So I'm just going to keep using the United States dollar. Maybe that use case will be adopted one day, but it ain't happening anytime soon. People are perfectly happy with their fiat currencies as long as they're functional. And as soon as there is a catalyst, such as, I don't know, more fiat currencies collapsing, that could spur it along. But stuff like that, you don't know when that's going to happen. And in the meantime, what's the incentive to switch? There really is none. So anyway, that's all I got for this video. I am not a financial advisor. Do not buy or sell anything because of anything that I say or write. That would be a very, very, very bad idea. Until next time, to the moon, Lambeau!